Well, for some drivers, it's natural to turn right and left, and for others, it's not. And for me, growing up on the short tracks of the Southeast, it's a challenge. But that's something that we've got to work on. That's something that isn't going to be easy. But we've just got to put a lot of hard work into it, a lot of extra effort, and be smart the whole weekend. And running the Nationwide car is really going to help. Running the Cup car, we've just got to be smart and stay on the racetrack and maintain. That's not a track that we go and try to be aggressive and try to make up a lot of points. We've just got to maintain the points that we do have and get to the next one.
Road courses are the closest thing we have to short tracks, and honestly, the short track racing isn't as short track racing like it used to be as the road courses are now. I feel we are more aggressive on the road courses because you have, and you can't lift the guy up in front of you and spin him around like you used to with the old cars. So when you have the opportunity to spin him out from the left rear quarter panel and the right rear quarter panel, then you have better options. So I mean, it's just the way it kind of works on a road course. I'd say it's not that we try to do that. It's just that's part of racing. When you're trying to get your nose underneath the guy and he doesn't want to give up the place, then those things happen, and that doesn't happen. You only have the opportunity to hit him in the left rear quarter panel per se at the oval tracks.
Yeah, it is a much faster racetrack. I think it better suits a NASCAR-style vehicle than say, Sonoma does, but it puts on a great race. It's a totally different discipline, certainly challenging, and I look forward to it. I wish we had a few more years so that we could really polish our skills as road course drivers.
Not much. You know, it's kind of fun. You know, I like road racing. I didn't in the beginning. I wasn't very good at it, but sort of gotten a little bit better sense at it and how to do it, and so luckily we won this year's race in Infineon. That was cool and something special. We got the right brakes at the right time and had a fast car, and hopefully this time around at Watkins Glen we can do the same thing.
A little bit, you know, because you have to outbrake guys into the corners, really the only way you can pass, and when you do that, you're taking risks. You know that you can miss a shift, you can wheel hop, you can get into somebody, lock a wheel up, whatever, and so I think a lot of times when we see altercations at the road course, it's just somebody making a bold move and it doesn't work. It could be early in the race, it could be late in the race, but we saw that at Sonoma as well. I think it's just part of road racing, and in Watkins Glen, I love racing at Watkins Glen. It's a fast track that suits our cars, I think, very, very well as far as road racing is concerned.